Coming up, survival of the fittest. Next on Wild Discovery. Tomorrow on Wild Discovery. Wild. Run with a pack. And find out why hunting is a female game. The Sisterhood, as Hunters of the African Plain continues on Wild Discovery. Tomorrow at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, on the Discovery Channel.
These guys are persistent.
Well, they're no match for the world's first sport utility wagon.
Oh, really?
All-wheel drive Subaru Outback's got more headroom than a Cherokee.
Uh-huh.
The ground clearance of an Explorer.
So you say.
Ride smooth as any car.
Any more of those tidbits?
What, like more stability in a turn than a Chevy Blazer?
That'll do.
That's my Subaru Outback. World's first sport utility wagon.
It's art that tells me to break from convention.
It forces me to explore my inner self.
It commands me to think.
It orders me. A nice porterhouse.
The new private issue card. A work of art that really works. You pick how it looks, the features you want, even your billing date.
Visually appealing, yet delightfully utilitarian.
What's the card you designed? It's a private issue. Use it where you see the Nova sun.
My mom and dad are buying a home, so I get my own room all to myself. Mom says after we move in, I could fix mine up any way I want. And if my sister wants to bug me or something, she'll have to knock first.
There you are.
Come on, let's go.
At Fannie Mae, we're the nation's largest source of funds for mortgage lenders. Call us for a free guide to help you find the mortgage that's right for you.
Evidence sheds light on secret ceremonies of the dark. Explore divine magic, the world of the supernatural. Beginning tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central. Only on the Discovery Channel.
For the world's first sport utility wagon.
Oh, really?
All-wheel drive Subaru Outback's got more headroom than a Cherokee.
Uh-huh.
The ground clearance of an Explorer.
So you said.
Ride smooth as any car.
Got any more of those tidbits?
What, like more stability in a turn than a Chevy Blazer?
That'll do.
That's my Subaru Outback. World's first sport utility wagon.
The Murphys will rob.
Really?
Yes, rob.
Poor dears.
Don't be the next victim of an energy-robbing furnace. Instead, start saving up to 40% on your heating costs with a Weathermaker from Carrier. The world's most energy-efficient heating system.
Do you think they'll ever recover?
Yep, up to 40% a year.
Wait!
Call your Carrier dealer today. It'd be a crime to call anyone else.
For a free brochure and a $100 certificate towards your next vacation in Singapore, the most surprising tropical island on Earth.
Tomorrow on Wild Discovery. Wild. Run with a pack and find out why hunting is a female game. The Sisterhood, as Hunters of the African Plain continues on Wild Discovery. Tomorrow at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, on the Discovery Channel.
New evidence sheds light on secret ceremonies of the dark. Explore divine magic, the world of the supernatural. Beginning tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central. Only on the Discovery Channel.
You are not the first. Millions have
come this way before. Many more will come after. And yet, you are unique. There is no other life experience, no other mind, no other body exactly like yours. Which is why we offer so many different healthcare options. Because while your path is not new, you will always feel you were the first to walk it.
Introducing a new luxury vehicle with the most powerful V8 in its class, dual airbags, and the ability to take you where no luxury car can. The new Jeep Grand Cherokee Limited. With over 40 major advancements, it's truly the perfect luxury vehicle for whatever nature unveils.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer for the best in automotive sales, service, and value.
Before You Move, next on Wild Discovery.
This program is brought to you in part by the totally new Ford Contour.
Ford Contour brings you a world of innovative performance ideas, like the powerful yet efficient Z-Tech engine, and the Duratec that can go 100,000 miles before its first recommended tune-up, which is a long way down the road. Ideas like the quadrilink suspension, so smart, it allows your rear wheels to adjust in sync with the front for more precise control, and that's a turn for the better. The totally new Ford Contour, a world car for the 21st century, well equipped for just $14,670.
Today, in hospitals everywhere, medicine will be mixed, linens washed, and babies will get their first taste of a new world, all with the help of one company.
Hey, Culligan Man.
Culligan, the world source for better water.
This could be your arm. This could be your chest. These could be your shoulders. This could be your thigh. This could be your stomach. This could be your back. This could be your body. This could be the way. The Soloflex Muscle Machine. Call now for a free brochure.
Choices! You gotta make choices.
Hey, kid. You wanna fly? You gotta buy.
No!
Exercise the right choice.
Visit your local park and recreation department today.
New evidence sheds light on secret ceremonies of the dark. Explore divine magic, the world of the supernatural. Beginning tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central. Only on the Discovery Channel.
Tomorrow on Wild Discovery.
Wild.
Run with a pack. And find out why hunting is a female game. The Sisterhood, as Hunters of the African Plain continues on Wild Discovery. Tomorrow at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, on the Discovery Channel. Next, why do they do it? How do they do it? Find out on the world's greatest stunts. Then explore the world of witches on Divine Magic. And you're invited to a virtual wedding on Next Step, coming up on the Discovery Channel. Discovery. Ladies with a taste for the kill. Run with the pack and find out why hunting is a female game. Hunters of the African Plain continues on Wild Discovery. But now, they must be crazy, right? The conclusion of the world's greatest stunts. Next on the Discovery Channel.
A motorcycle and an airplane. Their timing has to be perfect. A water skier and a boat pilot about to attempt 3 world records. And a motorcyclist on a deserted highway chasing 2 18-wheel tractor trailers for the jump of his life.
Hi, everybody. I'm Roy Firestone. We're here at the Miami Marine Stadium near Key Biscayne, Florida, just one of the fabulous places where some of the bravest professional stuntmen are about to risk their lives attempting the most thrilling and dangerous stunts you've ever seen.
And I'm Kathy Ireland, and in just a few minutes, we'll go behind the scenes to show you just how these world-class athletes undertake the kind of real-life challenges you never see in the movies.
Welcome to another edition of the World's Greatest Stunts.
From around the globe, these are the world's greatest stunts.
Hi, I'm Susan Anton, and I'm here on this abandoned stretch of highway in the middle of the Mojave Desert, where motorcycle jumper Johnny Airtime is going to fly over two 18-wheel trucks as they convoy down this road. It's a unique challenge and guaranteed to make Johnny Airtime a real-life road warrior.
I'm Annalicia, and I'm standing on this historic airfield outside Paris, where world-famous stunt engineer Remy Julien and his action stunt team are going to attempt a spectacular, world-first three-way adventure in the air. We're going to fly this plane down this course. Then we're going to jump this car over the plane. And we're going to jump this motorcycle over them both. We call this stunt Dangerous Crossroads.
And from this scenic cove along the Atlantic Ocean, just off the coast of Miami, Florida, world champion freestyle water skier Dave Reinhart and world-class boat pilot Mickey Giacomazzi will attempt to set three world records in a single stunt.
At speeds up to 70 miles an hour, Mickey will pull Dave across this bay, launching him over this ski ramp for a world record height and distance jump.
Then Mickey will launch his boat off this ramp, sending it further in the air than any boat has ever gone before.
I can't wait to see it.
Yeah.
But before we do, let's join Susan Anton in the Mojave Desert, where motorcycle stuntman Johnny Airtime is undertaking his own unbelievable challenge.
Again, if you think I just performed that stunt, thanks for the compliment. Actually, it took the skills of an expert, professional motorcycle stuntman. Now, in the movies, they're able to use trick photography and stunt doubles and hidden rigging to create an action sequence. But on this show, what you see is what you get. No tricks, no gimmicks, just careful planning and months of testing. And a lot of guts. We're here in Black Mountain, Nevada, on a strip of deserted highway that you won't find on any modern map, because stuntman Johnny Airtime wants to attempt something that wouldn't be allowed on any public highway anywhere.
This makes the Cross Your Heart bra look like a piece of dental floss, doesn't it?
Airtime's preparing a world-first ramp-to-ramp motorcycle jump that's never been tried anywhere before. But it's what's between the two ramps that's really going to make this a wild ride. These two 18-wheelers are each about 60 feet long, and then you line them up one in front of the other, and you attach a jump ramp at the front and the back. Well, you're looking at a total length of about 200 feet. But with the truck speeding forward at 30 miles per hour, that distance will actually increase while Johnny's in the air. Johnny will have only an eighth of a mile to get his powerful 500cc motorcycle up to speed.
Then he's going to race up from behind, jump the rear truck, sail about 200 feet, and if all conditions are good, to land on the ramp attached to the front truck.
If anyone can meet this challenge, it's Johnny Airtime. When we last saw Johnny, he was facing off with a speeding locomotive.
train jump was challenging because I had to have perfect timing on the jump. And when I was in the air, the train was going under, so it shortened the length of the train. This time, the obstacle is going away from me at 30 miles an hour, so I have to overcome that 100 miles an hour of actual ground speed. It's going to be very hard. I expect a tremendous challenge. It's very, very difficult to overcome the forces of wind, helmet buffeting. Your head just moves around like this. You're trying to read the speedometer, and your head, your eyes are jumbling up, and your speedometer's bouncing at that speed. It's really hectic. The ramp's coming at you. It feels like you're running into a brick wall at 100 miles an hour. The other thing, which is major as well, is when I jump off the pavement onto the launching ramp, because that's going to try to pull the bike out from under me and loop me out. The launching ramp could start wagging back and forth too much and wag me off course. The big dangers are coming up short from the wind slowing you down so much. Come up short, go over the bars, tumble down the ramp, something like that. That's probably one of the worst things that could happen.
Even if I keep everything together, which is very, very difficult on the actual stunt, coming off the landing ramp and meeting the onrushing pavement is like stepping on an escalator that's doing 30 miles an hour in reverse.
The combination of all those things produces the most dangerous motorcycle jump ever done.
Johnny's no stranger to dangerous jumps. In 1988, he performed a spectacular building jump with a nearly disastrous ending.
When I landed, the front hub broke into six pieces and 30 spokes broke, and this is what remains of it. And since then, I had a new one built that's much stronger, and this will never happen again.
Perhaps the need to fly and the courage to risk his life is hereditary. The son of an Air Force pilot, Johnny began his motocross racing career at age 14 and was winning international competitions by the time he was 17. Johnny set out to become the best in the business and soon graduated from winning motocross competitions to thrilling audiences with his gravity-defying jumps. Johnny's record for spectacular jumping may never be challenged, unless it's by Johnny Jr., who at 2 years old seems ready to follow in his father's footsteps.
There you go. Hang on the handlebars. Can you do a cross up? Cross up. Cross up! Yeah! Look at that cross up. Can you do a no hands? Can you do a no-hander? Yoo-hoo!
The world's greatest stunts will return in a moment on the Discovery Channel.
Attorney General Robert Kennedy. Teamsters boss Jimmy Hoffa. See Rivals, RFK and Hoffa, Friday at 10 Eastern, 9 Central, only on the Discovery Channel.
As Charlie sat wedged between the fleshy flyers staring remorsefully at the no smoking sign, he kicked himself for having left his Wrigley Spearmint gum in the change tray at the X-ray machine. Suddenly, he remembered he had another stick. Yearning for that cool, clean spearmint taste, that pure chewing satisfaction, he reached into his pocket. Not there. Then he saw it, beckoning him from the cuff of his pant. But his tray table was down, mocking him.
When you can't smoke, don't forget your Wrigley Spearmint.
The third baseman? That's my son. I'd like him to grow up in his own home. My friends gave me some tips on how much I can afford to spend, but it didn't sound right to me. I may have to wait until my boy makes it big in the majors, and then he can buy the house. Or maybe not.
At Fannie Mae, we're the nation's largest source of funds for mortgage lenders. Call us for a free guide to get you started on the path to home ownership.
A flower is perfect in every way. You, however, could use some work. The Soloflex Muscle Machine. 32 real weightlifting exercises with none of the hassles of free weights. Call now for a free brochure and video.
New evidence sheds light on secret ceremonies of the dark. Explore divine magic, the world of the supernatural. Next, on the Discovery Channel.
cable company. Haven't you heard DMX yet?
By visiting Something Fishy, Minnesota's marine life specialist. Something Fishy is Minnesota's largest marine life store with over 15,000 gallons of tropical, fresh, and saltwater fish to choose from. The marine experts at Something Fishy will help you create the perfect marine environment for your aquarium. Something Fishy believes in preserving coral reefs. That's why we carry only hand-caught marine fish. For the true enthusiast, visit Something Fishy at 1236 East 66th Street in Richfield or call 861-6675.
Turn to the world's greatest stunts on the Discovery Channel.
For years, Johnny has designed and constructed his own jump ramps. But engineering this first-ever moving structure for ramp-to-ramp jumping would prove as challenging as the stunt itself. The ramp structure will need to stay in perfect alignment with the powerful semis as they move down the road. Welded out of steel tubing and a plywood surface, the giant ramps were built to slide directly on the pavement for stability. Too much vibration or swaying of the launching ramp could throw Johnny dangerously off course. The crew took great pains to stabilize each joint and connection and reduce the risk of vibration. With the countless miles of testing on the unforgiving asphalt, problems began to surface. Slide plates wore thin and had to be replaced. Steel beams began to weaken. The constant modifications after each test run slowed down construction, and the weather turned nasty. An unrelenting icy rain forced the crew to work even slower, and the sub-zero nights put a film of deadly frost on the jump ramps. The bitter cold made any kind of practice jumping impossible and caused tools and equipment to break. Johnny decided to add a protective apron over the cab of the front truck so that if he comes up short, he won't crash land into the driver's seat. But the added height could prove to be a big problem.
Usually your launching ramp's like this and your landing ramp's like this. Well, I've got that.
With stunt day fast approaching, Johnny was running out of valuable practice time. First, Johnny had to get used to jumping up and over the protective apron to reach his landing ramp. Then he gradually increased his jumping distance. Finally, Johnny was ready to attempt the full 200 feet with the truck stationary. Stunt coordinator B.J. Worth worked with Johnny, measuring each jump and marking his landing point so that Johnny could get a sense of the exact speed and height necessary to land on the downslope of the ramp.
Well, I'm clearing the apron over the cab without a problem, but when the trucks are moving, it's going to be harder to pinpoint my landing.
The landings look really good. They're real smooth. You're setting it down in a nice spot. But like you say, once the trucks are moving, all that's going to change.
Johnny wasn't the only one who needed practice. Stunt drivers Fred Smith and Matt McBride will need to keep the powerful semis perfectly in line and their speed at a dead-on 30 miles per hour.
Focus on straight steering right now.
The stunt crew had planned for a week of intensive training to make sure that the drivers were comfortable with the added weight of the big ramps and with the way they affected the handling of the trucks. Now, Johnny has only 2 days to drill the drivers. First, one truck at a time, and then both trucks together in line. Both men were chosen for their extensive racing experience, which Johnny knew would help them maintain their concentration during the long, tedious hours of practice.
Most of the stunt stuff is a crazy type of thing off the seat of your pants, where here it's a little more precise. You have to take your time, make sure everything's straight, because we don't want anybody to get hurt.
But 36 wheels and 20 tons of steel won't stop on a dime if anything goes wrong. So the instant of Johnny's landing is critical.
Danny gives me the cue as soon as Johnny hits down on the off-ramp. At that time, I brake. Smooth and steady, bringing it to a smooth stop, allowing him to just glide off the off-ramp safely.
But on the last day of practice, Johnny met with an accident on his first attempt to mount the moving launch ramp. A member of Johnny's crew captured this footage on home video.
Hang on, man. Hang on. Don't move around.
Your hip all right?
Yeah,
it's gonna be bruised, but it's all right.
You sure?
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah, I'm all right.
Hands okay?
Yeah, everything's working. It's just slithery, you know?
Yeah, it's a little broken, not going to pick it up with a knife.
Tape it? Take it off.